but you just go on in the hope that I have lost my child, maybe I can help other people to take better care of their children. But I don't see why in this country we can't stop politicians with criminal charges from sitting in the legislative assemblies and the legislatures. Even the Supreme Court has not been able to make these people implement the police reforms in 6 years. How do we expect a change?
Well, I don't know. In the Vikas Yadav case, which you fought, in the Manu Sharma case, in the Ruchika Girotra case, and now in this Gitika Sharma case, the system has never been on the side of the victim. Yes, Mr. Yes. Memon.
Arnab, if I can be heard now, am I audible?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry, I lost. I'm sorry, Mr. Memon. I think I've just lost the line with you again. Yes, Kiran Bedi, I'm going to come back to you. Extremely sorry, Mr. Memon. Yes, Kiran Bedi.
Arnab, our entire criminal justice system is accused-based. It is not victim-central. It is all about rights of the accused. We never talk about the rights of the victim. It is not victim. Victim is not central to the criminal justice system. Our accused is central to the victim. So all human rights concerning or accused, there is nothing called rights of the victims. Unless we shift the system and make it victim central and balance the victim and the accused, we will not get the right justice for the victims. I think that's the key. The point is, you got human rights all about the accused. Where have you ever been fighting for, ever have you seen a movement or a fight or a human rights commission for rights of the victim? The victims which die of terrorist attacks, victims which die out of a lot of atrocities? No. We talk about rights of the accused, the medical of the accused, the reforms of the accused, the expeditious trial of the accused. What about the rights of the victim? Victim is dependent entirely on the government lawyers. And what kind of government lawyers sometimes we give them? So well, I think what is important also to propagate and understand is, let's reposition
which high-profile lawyer, which high-profile lawyer, Gopal Majid Memon, which high-profile lawyer actually agreed to take up the case of Geetika Sharma?
Now, please permit me a couple of minutes now. I have lost my chances earlier when I wanted to convey some very important facts. Number one, I wanted to say this, that this pathetic situation today that we are facing, low conviction rates, offenders are merely continuing, law does not reach them. Even if law reaches them and books them, they can conveniently get out. There are no convictions. There is no fear. See, the problem is that a powerful and a rich offender has lost fear in law, and the victim of the crime and the common weak people have lost trust in law. Both will have to be restored. It is if only then you will get results. Now, in the instant case, first, Arnab,
no, we that's all very well. That's all very well. But what? No, that's all very well. But what action was taken? Mr. Memon, that's all very well. But what action was taken for defaming Geetika Sharma's character? Let me ask you here. What action was taken by the police?
Please give me one more minute.
No, they will file another. 1 minute, Mr. Memon. Mr. Memon, they will file now a fresh FIR in the case against Kanda and Chadda, which will amount to absolutely nothing. There's no FIR filed for defamation. There was no action which was taken against any of the politician who further defamed the girl. This added to the trauma of the family. Pressure was put on the family, and all that the police will do is now file a fresh FIR. So it amounts to nothing, Mr. Memon.
Arnab, give me 1 minute. Please.
No, tell me in this
please
case.
Give me 1 minute.
No, tell me in this case, how was an example set? Here was an opportunity to set an example. Do you concede that an opportunity was lost?
Please tell me, Arnab, please. Arnab, let me know, let the audience, let the viewers know whether this mother is a witness in that prosecution case. Do you know that? Is she a witness? If she is a witness, it becomes a very grave act today if she has committed suicide, because that would mean that if there is an attempt to temper and destroy evidence, because if she has been forced or coerced to end her life, and therefore she does not remain available as a witness, it amounts to a serious crime. It compounds the gravity. So therefore, we will have to first find out. And Kiran Bedi is saying written complaint. I don't fully agree with it. Even if she has not lodged a written complaint, there are adequate circumstances. There will be a lot of evidence to suggest that this mother was also under duress. She was being persistently harassed. There can be lots of various circumstances.
No, you have not answered my question. My question was,
yes,
she
please.
Commits suicide in August 2012. Consider the facts one minute, Mr. Memon, please.
Yes.
Let's not look at it theoretically.
Yes.
She commits suicide in August 2012. 6 months later, the charges have not been framed. I want you to consider the plight of the family. First, the trauma of losing Geetika.
Right.
Then the administration, Kiran Bedi, goes slow on arresting Gopal Kanda. Ruling party politicians line up defending Kanda. In public platforms and in rallies, they denigrate Geetika. They call her a servant who was aiming for too much. And the legal battle has not begun. That's where the situation is, Kiran Bedi. So the entire system...
No, why is the charge not framed?
Well, that is something that the prosecution must ask itself. Clearly, it is very easy to slow down the work of the prosecution, Kiran Bedi.
That's exactly what I'm saying, that our entire legal system, thanks to our legal fraternity, is accused-based. And that they get the best of the lawyers. Who protects the victim? Who defends the victim? So this is not victim-central. If today we want legal reforms, I'm telling you to let the bar councils come out. Let the bar councils make judicial reform their movement. Let them stop taking adjournments. It is they who are all the time seeking adjournments and delaying the courts. And then we don't have tough judges to say, sorry, no, despite the amendment of the Criminal Procedure Code, that adjournments would not be allowed. Why is it flouted? What about the voice of the bar councils of India? I think if you want judicial reforms, it is in the hands of also, respectfully, also in the hands of the bar councils. I want to know what kind of collective voices
yes,
have the
Majid
bar councils come up with. I want to know that.
You see, no, this is all right. You see, you are expressing your anguish. We respect it. But let us find
no,
out
she's,
what
she's
is the...
No, she's not expressing her anguish alone,
Supreme
Mr. Memon.
No, Arnav, just give
no,
me
no,
one.
Mr. Memon, yeah,
please,
she's not expressing her anguish.
Later,
she's, no, Mr. Memon, she is representing the fact. I am telling you, Mr. Memon, I'll pick up the Ruchika Girotra case. What happens when not just a family, but other people want to fight on behalf of the family? The friend in the Ruchika Girotra, the friend Aradhana had a case filed against her. The lawyer who took up Ruchika's case had a case filed against her. Cases for compensation and defamation were filed against her. The journalists who tried to pick up the case had criminal and civil cases filed against them. In other words, a powerful person sends out a message that you cannot mess with me. I will get the whole system to work against you. I will slap case after case against you and the family will have to fight alone. Once you achieve that, then you get the prosecution to go slow. You frustrate the family. You don't even have to intimidate them personally, Mr. Majid Memon.
Arnav, this is a case, what instance you have given now is a case of gross miscarriage of justice. We have to concede. There are a number of such cases where we find that interests of justice have been compromised, either by powerful politicians, rich people, or etc., etc. This is what the truth is. We can't just shy away from this. And therefore, we need reforms. We need police reforms. We need judicial reforms. We need a system also to be revamped. We need a proper witness protection program. We need victims' plights appreciation by the courts. As rightly said by Kiran Bedi, I endorse it, that unfortunately victims are taken care of by such prosecutors who are no match to defense counsel. And unfortunately, nobody bothers. And therefore, justice suffers. That is how we have very poor conviction rates. We have been debating this.
Well, I think what has happened today should leave us all to think what happened to Geetika Kanda. Not one lawyer came up and actually chose to fight for Geetika Sharma. Not one lawyer came up. Everyone talked about it when she committed suicide. Not today. We are following this story up. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us.